Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Can you hear me?
I want to welcome you to the presentation titled Safety on Construction Site. My name is Salami. Salami.
Salami.
Salami.
Salami.
Actually, people call me after Salami. But Salami wasn't from Nigeria. There's a culture in my country among the Yoruba. They share the Arabic. Very hard ones to pronounce. They change to the one that's easier for them to pronounce. So instead of Abu Salam, they say what?
Salam.
Instead of Abu Aziz, they say Lasisi. Any Abu Aziz here?
Mashallah.
So you are Lasisi. Alhamdulillah. So basically, we are going to be talking in the safety of construction sites. Has anyone seen this kind of image before? If you have seen it, let me see your answer. Almost everybody has seen that, right?
Yeah.
So there's a safety first. But the very, very shocking thing is the construction industry has the most fatalities than any other industries we have. By fatality, I mean, you see people breaking their bones. You see people having cuts in their neck. Very, very dangerous places. So most of these hideous accidents occur in the construction industry. Yet, we say safety first. Do you understand?
Yes.
So this is taken from the Bureau of Labor Statistics. This is a data amongst one of the data we took in 2004. And this is the slide here. So we're going to be looking at safety within the confines of construction. So for us to be able to understand what this is all about, we have to look at the construction life cycle of a project. For instance, we have the initiation, we have the planning, we have the execution, monitoring and control, and also closing. So we try to divide this into what? Pre-construction. Pre-construction means before the construction. Then we have the construction, which is the stage where we execute the job. And also we have the what? The post-construction, which is what? After the construction. So within these three, headings, we want to look at the safety requirements within them. So we're starting with the pre-construction. This is another data taken from the European Foundation for Improvement of Living and Working Condition of Workers on Site. It says what? 60% of fatal accidents occur where? 60%. Due to the what? Decision made before the what? The site begins. Before the site begins means what? The pre-construction work stage. So before the project starts, we're already recording what? Fatal accident. Why? Because some of the decisions they took before the construction were what? Wrong. Right? Or were not enough in the design stage. So people are already dying in the design before the construction.
Yeah. How can you decide this? It's more...
In subsequent slide, I will try and explain that to you.
Okay.
But so you say that the decision making, starting and plan.
Yeah.
There is fatalities in any, and when you start to work the.
This is what I mean.
Oh, okay.
If you are going to Alaska in the U.S. is one of the coldest places in the U.S. for instance.
Okay.
You are going to Alaska for instance. You know it's very cold. Would you go with your civilians? You understand?
Yeah.
So before you leave your house, if you're going to Alaska with a singlet, somebody will tell you, yeah, Ahmed, you want to kill yourself.
Oh, okay.
Do you understand now?
Yeah.
So right from the design stage, what I mean is metaphorical. People are already dying. You don't know, you're just designing. If you want to save people, you need to bring the safety idea into what? Your design. Okay, I want to build a house now. This is like 5-story building. I need to put an escape ladder somewhere, right? For people to what? To escape. Look at this room, for instance. Look at the eye. There's nothing in here for me. Do you understand?
Yes.
Meaning, the guy that designed this did not put in mind the safety requirement by what? Maybe the NFPA, for instance. So there's a safety requirement here that is what? Not given to this design. Do we understand?
Yes.
So if there's fire here now, the fastest guy, even Usain Bolt, will not be able to escape this place. Why? Because there's Ahmed here, there's Abdulaziz here.
Yeah, we'll say that one.
You should be prepared before.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. Which is the pre. This prepare is actually what the pre.
We can start off.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
So you have to prepare.
Line, yeah.
Exactly. So for you to save 60%, what do you have to do? You have to prepare for safety in the what? Design stage. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Look at this graph. This is like the construction life cycle seen in another dimension. You start with the what? The conception, followed by the what? The detailed engineering, followed by procurement, construction, then what? Startup. Conception means I want to build a duplex, for instance, in where the mom.
The idea of the thing.
So the idea. Yeah. So in my house, I want to have a basement. I want to be able to park my car in my bedroom. My car. You know, you have this concept in your head. So you call in the engineers to look at how they could come up with this design, right? So you get to what procurement of materials are going to be needed. I mean, there's going to be needed for this because you're going to need a service elevator to carry your car to your bedroom, right? Without this, you cannot lift your car from the ground to your bedroom. So you have to procure a lot of things, right? So you go up to what the construction of what you had in mind, which is the concept. Do we understand?
Mm-hmm.
So we're going slowly. Then the startup is actually when they call you, yeah, Blazes, your house is ready. Can you bring your Ford and enter your bedroom? So you drive from ground floor to your the bedroom, which is the startup. That's when the project is complete. Do you understand?
Mm-hmm. So you're using the facility.
You said what?
You mean by startup, it's with the startup of using a facility.
Exactly, using our facility. Thank you very much.
Where's the...
Which one?
No, I mean the pointer.
Mm-hmm. Okay, this one.
Okay. Look at this y-axis. It says what? Ability to influence safety. And look at the what? The x-axis, it says what? Project schedule.
Yes,
which means, when you are having the concept in mind, you have high chance
to
incorporate safety requirements due to what?
The
whatever you're thinking. Okay, if I want to park my car very close to my bedroom, then I have to put a very big wall to protect my child from entry in case I want to reverse, any of my kids must not be there.
Mm-hmm.
Do you understand?
Yes.
So maybe the locks will not be at this point. The locks will be what?
Will be much
higher a bit. So that they will not be able to open the door and come in. So that's a safety thought in the what the concept.
Also the noise, like input insulation.
Exactly, a lot of insulation like you mentioned. Do you understand? Because when you start your car, my wife does not like noise. Yeah, put your car in the kitchen, but when I'm sleeping, don't wake me up.
Oh.
You understand?
Yeah.
So I need to put what? Insulation around the building. So that when I ignite the engine, I would not hear the noise.
Yeah.
Do we understand?
Yes.
So now, we move to the detailed engineering. So the idea of this, graph, for instance, is as you move down, the ability for you to influence the safety is what?
Reduces.
No. So immediately they start buying the materials for your building. You cannot tell them, I read in the NFPA that maybe a particular number cannot be used because of the smell. The smell is not good like this. After buying, you cannot do that, right?
Yeah.
So your ability to influence the safety of this material is what is becoming lower. Do we understand?
Yes, yeah.
So when we get to the construction, let's say you went to what's your name?
Mufid.
Huh?
Mufid.
Mufid.
Yes.
Let's say Mufid has a procurement company. You can go to him. Yeah, Mufid. Alhamdulillah.
Mufid, please, this material I cannot use again. Please, can you keep from here? You want this one?
Mm-hmm. You can still speak to him, right?
Yes.
But when you get to the construction, what happens? Nobody stops for anybody.
Yes.
You cannot say, we have to take this material. For instance, you bought the material from Spain, Turkey, or somewhere.
Okay.
When the construction starts, you cannot change.
Mm.
And you know that this material that you procured has some safety issues. So when you get to the construction, it's not very difficult for you to return, which puts you lower in your ability to influence the safety. Do you understand?
Yeah.
For instance, you finish the building now. Can you talk about safety again?
No.
No.
You already finished.
You live with it. You live with it. Or you do a rework. For instance, the wall between your garage, very close to your bedroom, maybe it's a CMU wall. The sun is so much. Then you can remove the old wall and put what? Maybe a glass. Soundproof glass. So that you won't be able to disturb your what? Your wife. How many of you are married here? Nobody. So, at this point, when you're having the concept, that's when the project starts, right? And it progresses. So as you progress, it's very difficult to manage safety. You will get the idea. If you don't get the idea, just raise up your hand, I can go back again. Do we understand?
Yes.
I want to ask you a question.
Go ahead.
Detail of engineering.
Yeah. That's why you have your design.
What?
You have your drawings, you have your specifications, you have everything. That's the detail engineering. You call the architect, you call the civil engineer, you call the mechanical engineer, you call the design. Like we have the HVAC here, by the mechanical engineers, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
we have...
I want to evaluate details of engineering.
Detail engineering is when you design everything, every facility you need for the building.
Okay.
The architects, the mechanical engineer, the civil engineer, electrical, all of them come together to give us all the detail engineering.
Which is the planning stage.
Exactly. Because the mechanical engineer will tell you that you need three projectors here instead of one, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you call Mufid. Mufid, please, I need three projectors. But I think one is okay. Mufid will say, no. You need to buy three. Why? Because for his business to grow, right?
Yeah.
And for you to satisfy the requirements by the electrical engineer for this room. Do you understand?
Yes. And about procurement?
Procurement is buying.
Materials.
What's your name?
Ali.
Yeah. Because Ali, I want to buy your shirt. It means I have procured your shirt.
Purchasing.
Do you understand? Purchasing.
Purchasing.
Exactly. Do you understand?
Okay.
Yeah.
So at the pre-construction stage, just to refresh your mind again, what goes on there? This slide will answer all questions we have in the graph. We have inception and feasibility studies. What happens there? That's where you have the project requirements. You study them. At times, your client does not know what they are saying. Your client will tell you, you know, I want to have my flat, you know, like 5 floors. I want to be able to move the last floor like this, move the last floor like this. You know, client, they come with crazy requirements.
Yeah.
I want to be able to carry the 5th floor and put it down. Like,
it's not legal to
do. You understand?
Yeah.
So you have to do a study of this project requirement. You have to study it. If it's possible, then you move to the what? Design stage. So all the possibilities of the inception and feasibility studies will be carried to the design. So you have agreed on what to build, how to build them, people to call. So you move here based on what the project requirement from here. Do we understand? Then after the design, we need people to what? To build, for instance, their house. You know about Mufid and so on, Sharkat Mufid.
Yeah.
You know Sharika Ali?
Yeah.
Yusuf.
You know Sharika Yusuf?
Yeah.
But you know that Allahi Ali built my house in Al-Hasa and you know, the wall was not good. I don't want to give to Ali again. I think Ali, or somebody told me had any good construction in Jeddah. And Yusuf made slightly good. So I just go to Mufid, right?
Yeah.
So this stage is what we call the tendering stage. Where you have to bring all of these people together, send them what you want to do, send to Ali, send to Mufid, send to Yusuf, and they study, and they come to you. Ali says, I'm going to build this for 1 million riyal. Yusuf said, I'm going to build for 1.2 million riyal. And Mufid said, I'm going to build for 2 million riyal. 1 million? 1.2, 1 million, 2. Okay. Mufid, please, can you come to my office? Why? Because his money is cheaper than all of them, right?
Yeah.
So this is what we do in the tendering stage. So after the design, you give all of them the design and tell them to send you the cost of the design. with which they will use to build the house.
Can you give me a like quotation for
Jazakallah khair.
Quotation. Send me your quotation. Send me your quotation. Send me your quotation. So when you agree, so we will choose. You will choose one person. So this is what we call the tender. But not always the cheapest is the best. Yeah, yeah, because maybe for the specification, maybe some, you see, one of the ways to arrest this kind of situation is in your specification. Yeah, in your specification, yeah, you can go the contractor like this.
He will not be able to go anywhere.
Yeah.
Why? I need the felt.
Okay.
But I need the same material that Malik Salman is wearing.
Oh, so
you put it in the specification.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
If he likes, let him make profit. I don't care. What do I care about?
Oh,
the quality of the felt.
The requirement that he needed.
Exactly, the specification. All of these requirements are written in the specification.
So
I need the same phone like Malik Salman. You understand? If you like quality $1, I don't care. Just give me this. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So this is the way we fight. You understand?
So you enforce him by the contract that he made with him.
Exactly. The moment he signs the document,
it's specify everything that you need.
Exactly.
Do you
understand?
When
we
come to construction site, if we build something, life of the building maybe 5 years and then it will collapse and be bought.
That's why you need to sign an agreement. There's what we call warranty period for every building. If you build my house, for instance, now, you have to sign a warranty period for me 10 years. After 10 years, within 1 year to 10 years, if anything happens to the structure, you're going to do it again free of charge. Majana.
Oh, okay.
Exactly. Do you understand?
Yeah.
But after 10 years, if anything
that happens, not fix people made up, die.
If people die, it becomes worse on you.
Yes.
You have to build my own house. You have to face the hukuma.
Yeah.
You understand? Because there's a lot of gharama.
Yes.
When people die, they want to collect money for
incentives.
You understand? For the people that died. So you have to face these people. This is why anytime you want to do anything, make sure it is right.
Yes.
Don't try to do Alibaba.
Yeah. Play around.
Exactly. Don't try to play around and try to say, okay.
So who's responsible for this construction site?
The contractor. If you sign a warranty period of 10 years, it is a contractor. Let's say this sign 10 years. Some people will sign 20 years with a contractor.
And he must pay for people who die.
Everything.
Okay.
Everything. He must build my structure new. One. How many people died? 5, 10 people. He must go to the hukuma and answer some questions. Because they will put handcuffs
on
him and take him away. Last thing he has to answer for that.
It's all about compensation, right?
Compensation, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
So approximately half of the what safety issues on construction sites arose from what? From what? Can we say it all?
Inadequate design.
Let's say it together.
Okay.
Inadequate design. You're not married. Even me that I'm married, I still have a power. So, inadequate design. So, the safety issues we have, approximately half of them come from what?
Inadequate
design. Then somebody will ask you, why? How? Right? Lack of safety education and training.
Yeah.
From the what? The design professionals. They don't know anything about safety. They just bring their software. Okay, you want to build factory building, they just analyze with their computers. StatPro, all these building softwares, AutoCAD, and all of them.
Yeah.
After this, they come up with the drawing without knowing anything about safety.
Okay.
This is one of the advantages of you learning about safety. For instance, Mufid, after finishing the safety program, he wants to be a civil engineer. Already he has safety knowledge, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
If Mufid is going to build a structure as a civil engineer, by the time he's building, he has a safety thinking in his head. It means I cannot put this here. Why? Because if somebody stands here, he's going to break into the floor. Like I stand here now. I want to drill this hole. This wall is just small thickness. By the time you drill this hole, for a safety guy, the safety guy will not start to drill the hole. Why? Because maybe somebody is at the other side putting his stomach in. What will happen? You drill the stomach. You understand? So the safety guy, before he starts drilling the hole, he goes outside and check. Nobody here, huh? Like that.
Oh, the connections, the wires are in the walls also.
Exactly, the connection, exactly. You have conduits here. Yeah. That is taking wires from here down and connection everywhere. But somebody without safety, obviously going to drill them down. Yo, man, what is that? So, we need what? We need safety, education, and perhaps, after graduating at the secondary level,
safety education is all for come on just safety mark.
I didn't get it. You said what?
Safety education for all who come and want to make the safety for the or just...
This is what I want to explain now. Safety education is what you are going through in the school now. The reason you came here is because you want to learn more about what?
Safety,
right?
Yeah. Okay.
I graduated from university now. Nobody told. I didn't take any course on safety.
Yeah.
Nothing. But when I start to walk,
you need
I need what?
I need training.
Do you understand?
Yes.
So there's a difference between safety education and safety what?
Design.
Training.
Safety design comes under what?
Education.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
So, like you for instance, you're in this school now. When I did my baccalaureate, no safety courses.
What is it?
Baccalaureate, BSc, baccalaureate, bachelor's, yeah. When I did my bachelor's, I didn't take any course in safety. So when you're talking about safety, Ali. If Ali is talking about safety, I need to keep my mouth shut. Right?
Because he knows.
He knows more than me. I don't know anything about safety. I didn't take any course in safety. Because he has the education, when he's talking, I only had a safety training. I cannot be as deep as Ali because Ali read the book. Ali took courses with maybe 4 or 5 lecturers. He took exams. But the training, maybe the training took me maybe 5 days.
Yeah.
He spent 2 years, right?
Yeah.
5 days. Are they equal? Even if you have a supercomputer in your head, you cannot compare all of them.
Because he spent too much.
He spent too much reading. Some people when they read, their head become bigger. Maybe same with Ali, right? But when you take the training makes the head smaller, right?
Yeah.
So when you compare the head with somebody that took safety education and the head of somebody that took safety training, are they the same?
No.
I'm talking metaphorically. It doesn't
matter.
The physical, yeah? Also, the safety designers, the design professionals, they don't have safety tools, design tools. Now, I don't have safety training. I'm a designer. I need to have some tools. For instance, there's a tool called Prevention Through Design, PTD. This is used in the US. This Prevention Through Design is like a step-by-step instructions. For instance, for structural engineers, if you want to do this, check for 1, 2, 3, 4. If you check for this, then your design is okay. You move to the next stage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Check your design through this. This is what the prevention through design is. There's another one, designing for construction worker safety. The difference between this, the reason why they brought this to, think like a design professional. When the designer is designing, he's only concerned about the safety of the building, not you. Right?
Yeah.
Not the workers. I don't mean you using the building, I mean the workers on site. He doesn't care about the workers on site. He only cares about his building.
Structures.
Yeah. Only. If Ali is working at the site, for instance, if anything happens to the leg of Ali, he doesn't care. He will tell you, please speak to the wood contractor.
Oh.
I don't know.
Okay, so that's the problem.
That's the problem. So you now understand why a majority of the accidents occur where? At the design stage.
Yeah. Because he didn't consider the human factor in it. Okay.
The most important thing about safety is to save what? Life.
Yes.
So the guy that is supposed to save life is not caring about life. He's caring about this that doesn't have nerves. Does this have nerves?
No.
But he's focusing on this.
He's considering fulfilling the requirements of the customer rather than save.
The workers outside, yeah. Very good. Do you understand now? So that's why we need to have the safety design tools. Because sometimes they will do the design and they will ask you, yeah, Ahmed, I don't know what the safety is. What is safety? Okay, I will do you a favor. I will give you some guidelines. I will give you some guidelines. Anytime you want to do your design, please follow 1, 2, 3, 4. If you follow this, then you'll be okay for safety during construction. So this is what these safety design tools are.
So you say that the design, it's not necessarily for the tool itself, like hammer and those stuff.
This is not the hammer and all of that.
Right, because in the first thing I thought that it's...
Okay.
It's not this tools,
this, those are tools.
Yeah.
This is also tool.
Oh, yeah, I know.
What I'm saying basically is, there are some tools that you can see.
As a guide.
You understand?
Yeah.
There are some tools you cannot see.
Yeah.
Do you understand? If they ask Chismak, Muhammad. If they ask Muhammad, can you describe
the taste of kapsa?
Please describe the taste for me.
It's pretty nice.
You understand? The tool you are using is your mind.
Yeah.
But if you tell me very nice, there are millions of things that are very nice. When I go to what I'm please give me very nice. You ask him, which of the very nice is? It's not easy. This fan of Yesu might be different from fan of Ali.
Yes.
But I want your own fan, because your own fan is very sweet. So I don't say, Muhammad, please describe your own fan to me. He's not able to describe it. But the tool you're using is your mind, right? For instance, I have a nail here. The tool I'm going to use to drive the nail is what? A hammer. So in this case, I can see the hammer. But in the case of Faham, I cannot see the hammer. So the tool can be physical or maybe cognitive, maybe in your mind. Do we understand?
Yeah,
you want to say something?
Do you mean the design method?
Design methods is what the designer is using.
It's related to different statements.
Let me give you an example again. I want to build a house like the Arab castle. You know this round Arab castle that has this thing on the head? I want to build. I cannot build it without asking Ali, for instance. Because Ali knows this culture very well. Mm. So can you guide me on how to build this? The tool you are using is your what? Your experience. Because you grew up in Saudi Arabia. You know everything. Right?
Yeah.
But I'm just coming from Nigeria and I just give me an idea of this design. I know the design to make it stay. But for me to build it safely,
shape it.
You understand? Shape it and all of these things, I need to go to Ali. So I'm using Ali as a tool.
To know what the tool we will use.
Exactly. For this particular thing. Mm. Do you understand?
Yes.
So design method is different from design tool.
Exactly.
Design method is what is inside the head of the design professionals. That's why they don't know about safety. Because they don't know about safety, so we give them the safety design tools. Please, when you're doing your design, just follow this procedure. Why? Why do they need to follow this procedure? Anybody?
Make the work safety.
Because of
safety.
Yeah. Do we understand now?
Yes.
Worker safety are left to the contractors alone. This is what we said here. They don't care about people working on site, they just care about their building.
Is that what you see?
Yeah, what we said now. They care about the emara, not the people working, the amal on the site.
Yes.
Okay.
Do you understand me? So one of the problem again is the wrong choices they made during what? Design and planning. Why do they make wrong choices? Because they lack what? Exactly. Exactly. Do we understand?
Yeah.
So now, before they used to ask themselves a question, after they get the requirement from the client is somebody that wants to build the house. Chismak? Murtada.
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 Okay, Muntavar.
Yeah.
Let's say Muntavar is a client now, he wants to build a house. So the designer will ask him, after they get the, they ask themselves, after they get the requirement from Muntavar, they say, okay, he wants his car to be very close to the bedroom. So they just ask, can it be built? This is where the designer starts from. So they pick their pencil and they start to draw. I put the bedroom here, you can put the soundproof glass, then you can put the car here. So the car can drive into the service elevator, and you can bring it down, and you can drive up. Okay? This is the only thing they worry about. But now, the thinking should change. So he has, the question he has to ask is what? Instead of, can it be built, it should be what? Can it be built safely? What is important here is what?
Safe.
It has to be safe. There's no point building your house like an aeroplane. And when you sleep, you cannot sleep. The house is shaky.
So you say that when the client wants some specification, but it cannot be built safely.
Yeah.
So I told them that I cannot make it in a safe way.
Because if you don't tell him,
you're
going to be in the city. Which city do you like? The one in the mom or...
Oh, okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
Because at that point, you need to tell him that what you have in mind cannot be built city. Please take it to analyze me. I cannot be
a
designer.
Okay.
So you can have innovation and design if that's what
you think. No, you can have innovations. A lot of innovations in design. But the most important thing is it has to be safe. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Think about anything you want to build. Because maybe because Ali cannot build, doesn't mean Chisman? Ablaziz.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean Ablaziz cannot build it. That's why we have many design engineers.
Yeah.
Okay. Ali cannot build. Let me go to another engineer. Let me go to Ablaziz. Ablaziz, can you study this design? Can you build it? Then Ali says, yes. Give me 5 days.
Everyone has its own way of doing
approaching
things.
Design.
Yeah, approaching design. So
maybe from Ali's experience,
it's
he has not built something like this before.
Yeah.
But from Ali's experience, his mind is always thinking about crazy designs. I think it can be built. Yes, it can build it. So I just take it to Ablaziz, please build it. And Ablaziz says, yes, I can build. But your yes, I can build must be what? Don't just say, I can build. It must be what? I can build
safely.
Because safety is very important.
When I make...
Somebody wants to ask a question there.
Sorry. I wanted to go to the other safety, but the budget is the issue. Right?
Your budget?
Yeah.
You want to build safely, but the budget is the issue. Then reduce what you want to build. Instead of using a flat screen, use a cheaper screen, use it for like 6 months, maybe money will come, you can change from flat screen, this one to flat screen. But the most important thing, you have to be alive, safety.
Yeah.
If what you are going to build is going to send you to the cover, why did you build?
Yeah.
Because if you go to cover, I will continue to enjoy here. You understand, living in my own very safe house.
Yeah.
So the most important thing for you is that it has to be what? Your building has to be what?
Safe.
Anything with safe.
Exactly.
Yeah.
What
imagine somebody has a car and it's going 150. on a road of 120. And there's a traffic in front. Is that driver safe?
No.
No.
What happens to the car? Number one. What happens to the guy? Just like free ticket to heaven.
Yeah.
You just go to couple. Just like that. Nobody cares. You see, the moment they carry this guy from the road, his car and him, what happens to the other people? They continue their life. The car continues to move.
Yeah.
Or they don't care about him again. Because they put him where he belongs, where? Cover. Maybe they will make his janaza, maybe that afternoon. And they just covered him.
Yeah.
Allah, okay. People will eat cups at that night.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
They will not care about it because he made what? Wrong choices. You can stay alive for as long as you want to. Build
make the right
safety into your thinking. Everywhere. You eat mouse, for instance, now, and you throw the pill here. Is that safe?
No.
If you walk around the pill and you go out, what if Mr. Ahmed, if he comes to the class, he will sleep. What happens to him?
He
will break his neck.
Yeah.
Allah, inside your mind, you will not feel happy because you know that Allah, I ate this mouse and I damaged his neck.
Mm.
So, in everything you do, you have to bring the idea of what? Safety. Do you understand?
I have a question.
Yeah.
When I make, when I make your decision.
Okay. To marry?
How can I?
To do what?
How can I make sure it's this is
right.
The most safe way or not?
Check the rest.
Okay.
So the paradigm shifts now in the way. Design question is ask to be what? Leave this big word. Paradigm shifts means what? You're thinking every day. If you want to make kapsa, you have to use gas. You have to use your cooker. I'm just explaining this paradigm shift.
Yeah.
But somebody killed. You don't need this gas. You just need this wood.
Uh-huh.
Put some kerosene gasoline,
yeah.
And put fire. You can also cook your capsules. You understand?
Yeah.
So the paradigm shift from using gas to using khashab.
So what? Change the perspective?
Like what? This is exactly the word. Changing what? Perspective. So now, we are changing from what? Can it be built? To what?
Can it be built safely?
This is a paradigm shift. Thank you. Now, I want to speak about this designing for construction work elevator. What do we mean by this? The short form is DFCS. The process incorporates what? Safety knowledge into what?
Design decisions.
This is why I like this. Do we remember what this is?
Yeah.
This is one of the safety design tools, right?
Yeah.
So why do we like it? Because what?
Safety.
It brings safety with it every time it's going to design. If it's going to design, his hand here is what? Safety. If safety is saying, no, I will not go, you have to go. You have to drag it along every time, yeah?
Yeah.
If you don't bring safety now into your design thinking will be like before 20 years ago. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Your thinking would just be like, what happened to Samsung, the one that was burning people's pockets?
Yes.
Wallahi, after that, what happened to the sales? Nobody wants to die. I don't want to burn my skin because I'm using Samsung. They lose money. So people are bringing safety into everything they want to do now. Because that product brought fire to you in the mind of people. They say, Samsung is dangerous. They have mobile phones are not safe. So they lose. So now, the key features of this process is what? The input of science safety knowledge into the design decision. Just trying to explain what we have in the first one. Do we understand? So immediately you want to start your design, just switch on your safety thinking.
Do we understand? A number of progress review ensure that safety is considered throughout the design. After the design from Mufid, I'll give it to Mr. Ahmed. Please, can you check this design from Mufid? He has put the safety requirements. Please, just go through it again. After he finishes one, you think this design is safe? I've changed the question.
Yeah.
Now I say check his design, right?
Yeah.
For him to work, if I tell him, Mr. Ahmed has checked the design, he will be like, he has checked, I think it's okay. But I changed the question with him. Do you think this design is safe? Immediately we'll quickly look at it. Like this. So he's going to tell me whether the design is what safe or not.
Why do we do this?
It's called review.
Okay. So from the review technique, we must actually change the question one.
So that you get
the most answer.
The most answer, the most benefit from this.
Oh, okay.
Because
if I tell him that this Ahmed has checked it, you understand? Yeah. You just sit down. Ahmed has checked it. Because he trusts Mr. Ahmed,
yeah.
He will not want to check.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
But if I tell him, please, can you check this? Very safe. You know why? I have made highly important. It means
he talks to the design, he'll be very happy.
Yeah, also.
He'll wait till I'm
so he takes the design and what?
He checks.
Yeah. So I will get the maximum benefit from his knowledge.
Yeah, okay.
Do you understand? So after you finish, we cannot call a meeting and discuss the design in general to know whether we're making progress. Because when you have design, you have different levels, right? Different level of design. So each of the levels have to be checked on what's safe. Okay, level one is safe. You think level two is safe. You think level three is safe. Please let me check the time. Three is safe. Like that. So the one here is what? The progress review. We understand what review is now, right?
Yeah.
So we have to come progressively. Not that I did the review in stage one, I'm not going to do stage two, stage three. What will happen? You are going to be killing people. The moment you think, yeah, I'm not checking for safety, just think about somebody might die from dying mistake. They will understand. Drawing and specification for the traditional design, they are not different from this one. They are the same. You understand?
Yeah.
After the safety check in your design, the drawings and everything, they are the same. But the only thing is that you have built a safe design into your own drawing because of your safety knowledge. He's a designer. He's a designer.
Yeah.
This designer does not know about safety. This designer knows about safety.
Yeah.
When they produce the AutoCAD design, it will look same, right?
Yeah.
But when you look well, you realize that, oh, Ali is a safety guy. He has put some comments here. When you are erecting this, make sure you have scaffolding of this feet. Make sure the scaffolding is having base plate of this size.
Yeah.
So when I read his drawing, I know that, oh, this guy has safety in his head. But when I read this drawing, there's no comment on safety. It's just, this is what you are going to build. Do you understand now?
Yeah.
This is what the last one is saying. So the drawings and specification, they are the same. But Ali has built safety into his design. Maybe the shape of the house is the same in the wood drawing. But when you look at the comment will tell you that this guy is calling to safety. If you don't have the safety requirement, don't build this. If you must build this wall, if you want to build this wall, make sure you have scaffolding of this height. The base plate is there. Braces and all of those things has to be in this angle like that for you to build this wall safely. Do we understand?
Yes. But someone in drawing the design, they will give you some notes, tell you you have to take this material, something like this.
Yeah.
Maybe they will give you the.
I understand your point. Like for instance, you have a material for this.
Yes.
For this one, you have to use the same. I mean, this mortar, semi block, and all of that.
Give you some company.
This is different. You understand? Many companies will come to you and say, our paint is good. But the moment you bring it to your house,
and you use willow VOCs, the smell from this paint.
Yeah.
The moment they paint the room and you come, you will not be able to stay in the room. This is not the wood. When they finish painting the room, when it dries, it should not be smelled. Are you smelling the paint?
No.
This is the way it's supposed to be. Because these chemicals going out of this paint, they are danger for your health. Maybe some of them do. Maybe. Maybe they will cause cancer to you. Maybe it will affect your lung. This is what it's
called.
If you are a designer and you want to specify this, just put the paint without VOCs in your drawing, for instance. Immediately I read this, I will know that, Abdullah. Immediately I read this, I will know that, this guy is a safety guy. But somebody that will say, provide paint with this brown color.
You didn't mention anything about safety.
So I can bring paint from one bush and just paint. Since it's brown, right?
Yeah.
But you have to take care of the health of people that are going to sleep. Because if the paint is smelly, you cannot sleep in the house. No.
So, in the blueprint of the design of the building, I should write the notes.
Exactly. That will show the safety education you have. Without this, you did not get safety education. Don't worry, don't disappear. Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
You have to have a design.
Is this safe or not?
Yeah, you have to do with the person who has study about the safety or with the person who will just have an experience.
You review with the guy. Because if you do a design, if I come and destroy your design, will you be happy? If you do a design, if I come and change some things in your design and I make it rubbish, do you like it? No. So you have to review with the designer. Sit down with me. Yeah, Abdullah. Yeah, Ali. This part you put here is not the required standard for safety. Because if the pressure in the bar, in the pipe is 5 bar, for instance, it's going to burst. And if it bursts, there's going to be a problem for the people living in the house.
Do it.
And you change the pipe to this thickness, maybe 2 mm thickness, with this ASTM standard. This is better for the household because this pipe is going to carry cold and hot water. If you put a pipe that carries only cold water and not able to carry hot water, what happens to the pipe? It will melt. Just imagine you're sleeping at home and your pipe is running from outside. It passes through your roof, passes through your bedroom to maybe the toilet, for instance. This is how they arrange the pipe. And this side in your bedroom, the pipe just broke. And it's like 2 a.m. you're sleeping. Maybe you're dreaming. And you just hear pop water in your cheek. You will not like this, right?
Yes.
So everything you have to specify the material, everything has to be up to the safety standard or the safety requirement of whatever structure you have. Do we understand?
Yeah. Okay.
So if you read through all of this, it will answer a lot of your questions. Now, take for instance, this is one of the suggestions. This is the way they design. People are asking me, how do I approach the designer for anything? This is how you approach the designer. You tell him, you give him as what?
Suggestion.
Because you don't go to a designer and tell, go to him here, change your design is wrong. I'm going to teach you. I'm going to teach you safety. I know safety. I'm going to teach you. This guy will get angry.
Yeah.
He will get angry. But you have to go him and give him what? As what?
Suggestion. That was right. This, if you look at the design prefab,
we know what the design prefab is. When you go to the construction site, you see some, what do they call? Some structures, temporary structures.
Yeah.
Offices. That the, at times when you go out, you see them carrying them from one place to the other.
Yeah.
These are prefabs. No?
Something.
Yeah, something like this.
Yeah.
They will understand. So, we just approach the designer and tell him, you see, these are design prefab units. Can be built on the ground and erected in place, not built above. Like, was been to Mecca, I mean, when we went to Mecca when they were, this Bin Laden were outside, they have these structures.
But we saw the.
Exactly, it was built above each
people.
Other. One of the risks in this kind of structure is people can fall from above mistakenly. I mean, somebody push and you can fall from there down. This is one of the safety hazards on site. That's why most of the time, when you go to the site, we don't build structures above. We put everything on the ground so that nobody will fall from above. If you fall from here to here, no problem. Maybe your bone will not break, or maybe something will shift here. I just like this for 2 days and they put it back.
Bruises.
But yeah, but when you fall from a big height, you may die. Because the moment your skull hits the ground and your brain have access to your blood, yes, I've seen somebody that had head injury. His head was in a motor accident. He hits the ground. And everything that happened in his life
is over.
From day zero till that time, he cannot remember.
Wiped out.
He was wiped out.
Roboted.
He was formatted. Everything removed.
He was asking me, do I know you?
I know me.
No. Do I know you?
This is somebody we spent 5 years together in the university. This is one of the hazards of falling. Wallahi, don't think this place is just small. I can fall. I can jump. You might fall and trip your leg and your head go and hit something. If you hit something, one of the possibilities is madness. You can go mad.
Yeah.
Another thing is you can lose your memory. You will not recognize anybody. Anybody.
You become disabled also.
I was talking to, yeah, disability, yeah. You can affect something in your neural network. And you cannot walk again. And may Allah save us from this.
Oh.
You understand?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So this is why this kind of suggestion could go. And why? It will reduce worker exposure to what? Falls and being struck by falling objects. Do you understand? So you go to the designer, all the prefab units, let's make them on the ground. So look at the drawing, okay, no problem. I will modify my drawing. Maybe before you made them above the themselves, you just go to him and tell him, okay, I will change my design. So you change this, and you just take this, yes. You go to the second one, design of underground utilities to be placed using what? Trenchless technology. Technology, anything excavation on site,
yeah,
is very dangerous. If you fall into it, if it's deep, the sand can bury you in the
labs,
and maybe nobody around to come to your rescue. That is why excavation. Sometimes you see the excavation and you think, no, nothing will happen. I used to go to the gym,
yeah.
I used to carry. Allah, if the excavation is very deep, and you forget about the gym. When there's, what's it called?
Movement in the ground.
Yeah, movement in the ground, and there's cover from this soil to just cover you there.
So bury them.
How many of you have gone to the beach, for instance, you bury yourself in the sand, in the beach,
yeah,
and your neck on you?
Yeah.
If your friend is not there, Allah, you'll not be able to come out yourself. I've done it before. They left me there, we're playing.
Yes.
You understand?
Yeah.
Please come. I was forcing myself, I couldn't go. This is just sand. But on site, we have what? Rocks.
Yeah.
To just be there for you to come. Mods even.
Yeah.
So that's why underground utilities can be replaced using what? Trenchless. Trenchless means what? Without excavation.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So this will eliminate the city as a city with what? Trenching. So you tell the designer again, allow adequate clearance between the structure and the power line. You have this power line going here, and you bring your, maybe the height is what, 4 meters, and you bring your structure to like 3.8. And here is, this cable, كبلات الكهرباء أليس هي what happened to you
my
vanity thought is why the whole building is so we have to avoid something like this so if you tell this to the designer he will think and he will change his design do we understand
yeah.
You can read the rest I will leave to the instructor so like just go through it and understand but you understand the concept right
yes
I just brought it so that you know how to approach the designers and how to talk to him this and that so the tools for your design professionals which they use can be found in this link like the first one this is my favorite they have 400 design suggestions
it's free
this is knowledge you understand
yeah.
So you just read through them and I'm very sure you're going to gain a lot of insights this is from the research of this tool guy they can I just brought it to share what they think. Very large percentage of construction accidents could have been eliminated, reduced, avoided by making better choices in what? Hello. Midway. If you make changes in what? Design and planning, you can eliminate a lot of what accidents. The same thing is said by this guy also. So now we want to see what the construction is. We have dealt with the pre-construction, right?
Yeah.
So this is the construction. So I'll go a bit faster here.
Yeah.
Okay? So what are the things you can find on construction site? This is an example. You see people working?
Yeah.
You see what cranes?
Yeah.
You see bobcats? You see excavators? You see what again? You see sand? You see a lot of materials around? You see cars? You see side offices like this. So it's a pretty, pretty dangerous environment to be in. Do we understand?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So these are people working on site. This is the way they look at, they look like. You have the laborers, you have the engineers, former supervisors, you have people looking at the drawing. So on the site, there are still little reviews that go on the site. Okay, I think we cannot build it this way, we can build it this way. So suggestion will come, especially if you have not built the structure. So look at this now. What is the hazard here? You see, this equipment is coming, and somebody is in front of this equipment. You understand? This guy who hit something on the way, maybe he hit a stone, he could fly to the guy, or this could be hit. This equipment can hit this guy. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Look at this. This guy is approximately under this. This is used to pour concrete.
Yeah.
Just look at the guy here. If there's a movement, when you have a cable with this bucket of concrete in here, it moves this way.
Yes.
Just imagine this thing is moving in this direction. What happened to this guy? It will hit the guy. And a lot of things could happen to him. Do we understand? And this is kind of excavation. This is, when you have excavation, this is exactly the way you retain the soil. You have something like this. Why? So that this soil will not come here, and this soil here will not come here. And this guy here is protected. But the problem here, do you know, is this electrical cable. Look at this cable. You understand?
Yeah,
anything could happen to this cable and it will affect the guy here. Especially when you have this to the steel. And if you look at them, they're made of steel. So this guy could receive what?
Electrical
shock. So, another one, this is coming down and this guy is under. This thing will fall down and kill the guy, right? Here, we have cuts in between. Don't always be in between objects like this on site. Do you understand? Somebody might be pushing it from this direction. And when you have cuts in between, he might not see you because look at the height of the guy. Look at the height of this.
Okay.
So he can crush the guy without even knowing. This is the example I brought here. Somebody is dreaming, and your friend is there at the other side of the store. What happens to him? It will just remove his intestine without surgery. This falling object, this guy can throw something. There is no hard hat. He doesn't have the helmet, or what do you call it? Hard hat, right?
Yeah, on his head. So if this guy throws something from the roof, what happens to the head of this guy? This one and this one. To fall on another, to cause injury. Look at this guy on the scaffolding. This guy does not have something to tie him to. Okay, what do you call this? Exactly. To connect him to this in case he wants to fall. Exactly. And look at this CME blocks also. The weight of this CME blocks can collapse this scaffolding. Look at it here and look at it here. Even if this guy doesn't fall, this load, heavy load from here, can collapse the whole scaffolding.
Yeah.
Do we understand?
Yeah.
And look at our friend here. Just standing. He's a carpenter. There's no what? There's no guardrail here.
Yeah.
We know what guardrail is, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. Class?
No.
You gotta put on the sides.
Have you seen this video? Right. Yeah. Pakistanis is very, very strong. Yeah, this is what they do. You know why? They like Hazard. But sometimes we used to believe that, don't do this, is when you start to walk on the bridge without guard rail. You understand? You know, people like to do stunts. You know the air devils? Yes. This is what they do. They like to do stunts. They go to the Burj Khalifa, the top, and they just jump down.
Yeah.
You understand? Not everybody can do this.
I think Mr. I think must study the behavior of some workers that they did not believe in safety. For example,
no, they don't believe in safety. Look at the daredevils.
No.
They connect themselves.
No.
They always, when they jump,
there's
a rope.
Yeah.
Because you know when they go down, there's concrete.
But now, Mr., you know, the money makes them log what they want. They didn't care about their
and many, many of them died.
Yeah.
There's a man in Malaysia, the BBC, 3 days ago.
Yeah.
He was this man in the village.
Yeah.
He is the one responsible to, you know, for bad, takes the snake.
Yeah.
This person, he knows how to
cobra.
Cobra, catch it.
Yeah.
Now, when the cobra hits him,
Huh?
And he died from this
sting.
Yeah. Because sometimes you think like, I can do it. I know this. But Allah, hey, maybe that's not your day. You understand? Maybe that will be sabab for this guy to die. So we just have to be careful.
Yeah. But Mr. Yani, for example, Yani, all of those Yani specifications that you must have a civil engineer on the agriculture, it's different from. What we may see, and we may see, for example, some Bangladesh people try to say that I can build this structure, and I can build, I can achieve what you want. But he didn't, believe it. So he didn't do anything for his safety.
If you drive at 150 kilometers per hour, it doesn't mean you are going to die that day. You understand?
Yeah.
When they talk about safety, they are telling you. To be safe, if you follow this safety procedure, if you spend 7 days following this procedure, you will not, hazard will not come to you. It doesn't mean that if you don't follow, that you are going to die that day. Maybe one day you did not follow, you just like.
This is the difference between the accident and the nearness.
Yeah, I know, but
exactly.
But now the research, I said that can we study and the behavior. Those workers that do this, why they did this?
We don't allow this on site. That's why we address them every Sunday morning, 6:30.
Yeah.
We talk to them about safety.
Okay.
If he doesn't follow the safety procedure,
His
salary will be cut into half.
Oh, okay.
You understand?
Yeah.
And then we give him 50%. They know this. If you don't put your hat on, add hat. We remove 100 riyal from the salary.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oh,
if it,
because I mean, I didn't tower.
Hey,
nice.
Hello.
Okay. Let's just conclude. So
people
have classes.
Sorry
for it. No problem. So these are some of the hazards we face on site. So for you to protect yourself from this hazard, what do you need to do?
Like
your feet. Just protect your what? Body. This protects your watch. Your feet,
helmet.
Your eyes, lungs,
yeah,
hands.
Is this area.
Look at this guy. Where is this coming from? This is the
guy. Yeah, I know. I see it.
Very funny picture. Very funny. But maybe this place is okay.
Yeah,
I'm saying. Maybe another place. It would just like.
Yeah.
This is some of my projects. This is the housing project. Look at the access to the site.
Awesome.
You understand? Look at the access.
Oh.
This is a real life project now. You understand?
Yeah.
So as a safety engineer, this is your work to correct on site. Do we understand?
Yeah.
Look at this. Here we have chemicals. Petroleum products here.
Yeah.
And it's kept this way on site. So as a safety engineer, you need to protect this, right?
Yeah.
Look at this. What is this? This is what?
Rest.
Housekeeping. Thank you. Poor housekeeping. And inadequate storage of what? Material. Because these pipes, they still want to use them, right?
Yes.
What is this?
Exposed.
Exactly. So you have crowded cables here. If anything happens here, the whole site will get burnt.
Yes.
So we need to what? Isolate the electrical parts. We use that or barriers, then we replace what?
Covers,
yeah. So here, this is just problem with scaffolding. Here we don't have base plates, no brazing here, and they are using, and the couplers here, they are using, instead of steel, they are using rope.
What's a coupler?
Huh?
What's a coupler?
Coupler is a part of the scaffolding that connects two parts.
Right.
You understand? You have this part here.
This X and H.
Which one?
This X and
cross.
The cross.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
To braze, we use it to braze.
Yeah.
Do we understand?
Yeah.
So this is a mall project. Look at the ladder they are using.
That's the new mall, right?
Yeah, the new mall. Who is the fattest in the class here?
This is Capital.
Who is the biggest? I need a big guy here. Who is the person?
Me.
Just man. If you stand on this ladder, what happens?
Yeah.
Exactly. look at this technology innovation, right?
Yeah.
What happens if this block breaks? You are going to Jenna.
Yeah. This is a problem.
This is what is happening. What you are learning.
Yeah.
Is what you are going to do when you see this happening. Look at the leak. If anybody throws the cigarette here now, what happens to this? This is petrol.
Catch on fire.
It will catch fire. Yeah. Look at the debris. No housekeeping. And the materials they are going to use, this is cement, and this is the Holocaust lab. We need to go very fast. Somebody is going to the class. Look at this. Look at this.
Yeah.
Instead of this cover, they use this wood. What kind of hazard is this?
Maybe
falling. Huh? You fall there, you break your leg, huh?
Yeah.
Will not come back.
So what can you do?
Your vision.
Exactly. So you can put something around it to protect people from there.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah?
This the duties of the safety engineer or
yeah.
The safety supervisor?
They do
this, the duty of safety engineer or the safety supervisor.
Because they are very stubborn. When you count the salary of two guys, all of them will find the old side very quick. So this is my parting shot to everybody.
Yeah.
You don't need to know the whole alphabet of safety.
Yeah.
You don't need to know everything about safety. But you need to know the what? The ABC of safety. Huh? Which will save you. And which is the ABC? What's the ABC of safety? So this is the A, this is the B, and this is the C. So you should always be what? Careful. Thank you for listening.
Shabab, all the time, that's the question you have. Thank you. If I ask you in my class, you have any questions? Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
We ask it for all the class.
Thank you very much. I'll give it to Sir Razor.